Hello, guys. Welcome to Sparker Cast, episode number 48. Tyrant and Damascus here, of course, holding it down for you guys once again. How's it going, bro? How's your week been?
All good. Getting bodied at work all week, but I'm good because it's weekend time. Gonna be able to finally rest a bit, and it never gets old to see Kid Buu getting bodied in that intro, as always.
Never gets old.
Shout out to show you Momo. But as always, guys, welcome to both the chats, my chat, Tyrant's chat, and the people watching right now on YouTube, Prime Advantage, of course, to episode 48. Damn, we're like 4 weeks away from a full year of Sparking Casts.
4 weeks away, and you know we're going to have to do something special once that is up. So yeah, we're going to definitely plan something cool for that. We'll probably have some more information on that next week or the week after, so you guys can prepare. But yeah, man, I mean, Super Baby's been out for, what, 2 weeks now? We've had some really, really cool tech shown, and it keeps on coming.
Yeah, definitely. There is a lot of tech, as always. People find a lot of stuff Super Baby in terms of like chemistry and everything. Of course, it's like less entries than before because, you know, Super Baby is becoming a normal character. Like, people have given him
the
classic, right? When the character comes out, the classic meme is 2 weeks. You give him 2 weeks, and after 2 weeks, you decide, is that my character, is that not? And that time is expired now. The people who play Super Baby now are the real ones.
Yes, exactly. Like, I've given him the 2 week treatment. I am going to stick with him. He fits so well on my team that I'd be silly not to. But, he does have some big problems. But yeah, we can go over that a bit later.
Yeah, definitely. And yeah, as a brazen butterfly in my chat, you can actually see the logos on my tab list for once. That's true. It's only about 50 entries today. So let's do this. Without further ado, we're starting with Man Like Super Baby and starting with some sauce. And first off is Talios having some fun with the character. Let's take a look.
All right, let's check it out here. In the meanwhile, thank you so much, Hamad, for the donation, brother. Really appreciate that. Let's go. Ooh, this is kind of nice.
A man like MVP Hamad always out there. That's kind of nice. I like the reach jump as well.
Yeah, definitely. Definitely clean.
So clean, corner, you get the weird side switch, you get the reach jump with this. That's really cool.
And that jump heavy reach jump is not the easiest.
Yeah.
I mean, I imagine on Broly it's a lot easier than the rest, but yeah.
I'm assuming, you know the rule, anytime you see a tech that's submitted with Broly as an opponent, it means it only works on Broly.
Okay.
That's usually what it is. Shout out to Talios for this one, really cool one. Second, I see him on my chat. He just got there. He says, I love labbing Super Baby 2. It's Choxa with other one. And he says, I think this is my favorite combo for Super Baby. Let's take a look. Yeah, same. You get the similar side switch, but then you get even more sauce.
Ooh, I love these key blasts.
These key blast combos are so freaking cool.
Yeah, they're really cool.
Look at this, man.
Ooh. Very sick.
He's basically doing Cell's command grab, but manually. You know, he's just like drawing it himself.
Yeah. Ooh, what? That was interesting.
Yeah, he's got two super babies because why not? You know, guinea opponents.
Yeah, of course. That's why. I didn't even see that at the start. I was just like, what's going on here?
Much love to Hamad, who's blessing my stream as well. MVP of the day.
What a king, man.
Appreciate the love. And I hope you appreciate the sauce.
Yeah.
This is mad cool. Like, these combos. Like, I kind of want to play Baby just to hit these combos online and then, like, not play him anymore.
It would be nice. It would be nice. Right now, right now, all you see online is just ABC dunk, you know, like, the easy stuff.
You need the acid rain loop and stuff, you know, because it's super cool. Shout out to Choxa for this one. A bit more sauce for Super Baby. This time this is Sans Alexander with his own entry.
That's kind of sick. Oh my god, that's awesome.
Look at this.
And that must be like, you know, small, medium bodies only, maybe.
That's like...
It's a funky looking combo. It looks cool as hell.
So it's side switch, then you get the corner loop, but in the middle.
Yeah. Style points maximum, you know.
Style points.
Damage points not so high, but style points are definitely up there.
Yeah, that probably only works on Teen Gohan with 1,000 with like 10,000 HP.
Yeah.
Like, yeah. Like if he actually has if his costume is actually like altered, the combo probably doesn't work anymore.
Left side of the screen only. Yeah.
Indeed. Up next, something pretty interesting. Steam Shrink, a funny command grab mix into more mix, but there is something really interesting about this combo. So take a look, right? You do a super, so you get like mad scaling.
Yeah, yeah.
And if you look carefully, while Super Baby does 214S, the multi-hits actually do zero damage. So you get this, the corner steal, that's cool, but watch it again.
Oh yeah, 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 let me see.
And look at how, I'm gonna try to like pose it when it's the case.
Look. Oh yeah, there.
They like these hits, it's so heavily scaled that the game was like, screw these hits, they're now zero.
It's, yeah, the combo was scaled in the way of damage, but not the hit stun decay. The hit stun decay was still low. So,
yeah.
You know, you can still do a full combo because he started with the supers, but yeah, yeah. I guess the actual damage scaling was just way up there.
Yeah, getting to all the way to zero is quite a lot, Charles.
Yeah.
Steamroller for this. Up next is quite a weird thing with Super Baby. You guys tell me if you can understand this, because even man like IP said, question mark.
One of the
classic.
One of the tech monsters. Let's have a look. because he switched over, right? But like, that's weird that they aren't all, they don't all come from the same side of the screen all the time, you know?
He didn't even change side. Like, I think it's because he swapped where he faced, because he was facing back.
Yeah.
And the Ki Blast made him face forward.
Yeah.
And you know, in Dragon Ball Fighters, a lot of the moves depends on which direction you face, not which direction you are right now.
Yeah, it's the block stun as well. It's like, yeah, the block stun. He was being pushed and stuff. So it's, yeah, it's very weird.
So I'm fairly sure it is. So if you take a look, right, we're gonna try to like make it frame by frame just to see if I can get this going. But so the first two, three are there. Then he's still looking at this side. So the first two are coming back, and now he's looking on the other side.
Yeah.
So the third one will go on the other side now. And then if you take a look, yeah.
Yeah, okay. Yeah,
it's
makes
really strange.
It makes sense. It's weird. Yeah. Yeah, it's, this game's so buggy with the characters' fate, like which way they're facing.
Yeah, it's just because, yeah, that game, like, characters turn around like really slowly in this game. So that's,
yeah,
like one of the weird things. But, you know, sandwich. Now find a combo with these guys.
Yeah, it's definitely interesting to test that.
Yep. Next one, the Prince Von showing a bit of chemistry, 2H combo with Teen Gohan and the one and only, you know, Baby B. Yep. Mm. Legs, get down and get the bomb loops after. Big damage, always.
So good. Gives so much to so many different characters, that assist.
Yeah. Yeah, 5.3k.
Nice.
You know of that? That will definitely work if you guys play these two characters.
I mean, it's good for Teen Gohan, who otherwise, you know, doesn't really have the most with 2H combos mid-screen.
Yeah, he will need the... Teen Gohan like, really needs like one of these assists to help him in this situation. Shoutouts to the Prince Von for this one. Another one is another synergy with Beerus this time.
Oh, nice. The raw tag in the middle as well.
Comes in and gets the re-jump. Like,
yeah.
Raw tag gets a re-jump afterwards. That's... And it's not the classic one of 6H, you know, that's a different,
yeah, exactly,
way to tag.
Oh, nice, nice. I like that.
That's cool, right? It's like, because the acid rain comes down, that's what extends the combo.
Exactly. I might have to do some tests with that. That looks really nice.
I'm assuming you might be able to do Vegito rejump with this.
Maybe like Gotenks rejump or something. Kind of sick.
If you have a two-hit rejump, you should be able to do this.
Yeah, Vegito might be the way.
Yeah.
That looks great, though.
Yeah, shout out to Taylor.
Very nice,
really cool,
as
one.
Always.
Up next, this one's actually pretty cool. So, Baby can use Base Goku B assist after the KO screen.
What? He can get extra
bar?
So
he's
bar?
Down, he's calling him now, and the bar is building.
Oh, that's cheap.
That is cheap.
So you can get the kill and get free bar? Look! He cancelled into it? Oh my god, that is disgusting.
That is literally free meter.
Bro.
That is literally the freest meter you could get.
That's so nasty.
Well, the cool kid, you found a good one.
Yeah.
Shout out to you.
that's one way to optimize your combos, you know? Get a full bar at the end for nothing, like...
Yeah.
Wild.
It's like, I feel like I'm having a bar as well, you know? So, that's the one. Next is mid-screen loops. From Talios.
All right.
So Janemba assist actually gives you the setup you need for that loop. And there you go.
Day.
Nice.
Nice.
So a good amount of damage, good amount of sauce as well. That's a very interesting setup as well to do the acid rain into the assist.
Yeah.
This yeah, and I'm assuming this only works on cooler, but only the cooler from the 23rd minute of the OVA. If you take the cooler from 5 minutes later, it doesn't work.
Yeah.
You know how it is. You know how it goes, guys.
That's how it goes with these with baby combos, man. It's so specific.
It's maximum specific, but Talios, thank you for this one. He says 99% certainty was tested on GT and for smalls and cooler cell for bigs.
Okay.
So it's probably like working on multiple characters.
Most, yeah.
Yeah, and speaking of loops, it's one like Dimer said, fuck ground loops. My homies love air loops.
Air loops? Okay. Air loops. All right, let's have a look. Show me some stuff.
Yeah, why would we go back to the ground?
Oh, that's too sick.
Yeah.
That looks so cool.
That's like, obviously, I'm guessing it's Broly only, you know, only Broly for the second movie, not the first movie Broly, otherwise it doesn't work.
Yeah, he has to have a scar on his chest, and it only works on Cell Games Arena.
Man said only work on East Coast, only works after 5 p.m.
Yeah. revived Broly only, you know.
Revived Broly only. Only works after Broly punched up Videl in the second movie.
do you know that movie annoyed me, you know, like there was so many problems with that thing. Why the hell is Krillin showing up, man?
And he's dressed as Piccolo?
Worst thing ever.
Like, no, you know what, that movie, I have like fun memories from that movie, because for some reason that I still don't know where it's from, my cousin managed to get a VHS of that movie that was in Japanese with no subtitles.
Okay.
I watched it in Japanese with no subtitles, that's all. I didn't understand anything, but I was like, let's go, it's Dragon Ball, I'm out.
I mean, yeah, when I was younger, I watched that, I was like, oh, this is not as good as the first one, man. The first one was way better. All right. I just played against this guy, man. I already had my fill of Nappa for the day, okay?
Well, listen, Nappa setup number 4,625.
Okay. Shout out to Plug, man.
Because why not? There we go. You get the plant. You get the vanish, and then good luck. Yeah!
So cheap. Frame perfect reset.
Big boys. Big boys.
Very nice.
I love this one. Shout out to Plug as always for showing all of the Nappa stuff. And that's it for Super Baby today. We had a lot of Super Baby, but it's time to give some love to other characters. And we start with Krillin. And this one is actually quite good. Look at that mix. Let me know, chat, press 1 if you got hit.
Okay. Krillin. Ooh. Whoa. That's nasty.
That's sick.
Is that like... That's not a jail. You can reflect.
Nah, you definitely can reflect,
yeah,
right?
Yeah,
because
yeah.
It's a key blast anyway, but...
Yeah.
But still.
Kind of nice. Solo, you know. I guess if he's limit break, you know, you're trying to just open them up.
Yeah. Yeah. That's like just a... Of course, you could level 3 the after image like a real DJ. Like a real DJ. You don't have cross-up protection if there is no assist, Kitetsu.
Let's be honest. This setup works if they're blocking on the ground. But this is Dragon Ball FighterZ where nobody stays on the ground for more than 2 seconds. So they're getting out of this. They're going to find a way.
You know, this game is 3 years old. Do you know how many times Tyrant have found a setup in training? And I'm like, yo, this setup is kind of sick. And, you know, I try and I'm like, yeah, okay, it hits cross-up, it hits same size stuff. And then I go play online.
No.
And everyone is just, like, face-rolling on their pads. And that beats the setup. And I'm like,
yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Well, you know, they can find ways out. You know, that. no setup you find is sacred, you know. Those Nappa
exactly.
ones, those Nappa ones maybe. But, okay. You know how
all
it is.
Right. Next is... so, okay, this is a how to outplay your opponents.
I've seen this. Okay. Show us. 10A, the Bueno.
Oh,
fiend.
You thought? Bro. Oh, you thought?
GT players, you better be careful.
You thought you would 2H me.
Damn.
It's good damage as well, you know?
Boo! That's like the large brain.
Yeah. Like, you know, no 2H allowed on this. Of course, I mean, you're gonna buffer this, right? You know, you're not gonna do this. You're not going to do this on reaction,
yeah.
But, you know, if you feel like it, go for it, man.
That's just
fun.
Yeah, that's just for fun.
Yeah, of course. Shout out to Tene for this one. Up next, it is Lily with some cool No, I believe. I feel like I've seen this before, but, you know, loops.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Simple, efficient. I love them.
They're just for fun.
I like these simple loops, you know. I like the loops that are just, like, simple.
It looks sick.
Like, you know me, I'm a fan of loop, guys. Like, as soon as I see loops, I'm down.
This is really sick, though.
I'm guessing it doesn't work on small bodies.
I don't see why not.
Yeah, I don't know. That would be interesting to see. Up next, listen, man, I've got to say something, right? Fenrich is really scary these days. Like,
trust me. This guy.
This is. Look at how much damage you can get off the Ultra Ignorance.
Oh my god.
The man is extending.
Oh no. Unrestrained. He's unrestrained, man. Bruh, Fenrich, please.
That is 6k and that's out of limit break. So, like, if he's in Spark and limit break, he gets a lot more than this. 6.3k.
Very, very ridiculous, to be honest.
6.3k of being in the corner and be like, I don't want your mix, man. Because, as well, remember that when he's in Spark, he's got the free way out. So, you tend to do it more as a UI player.
6.3k for getting knocked down. because you took damage, you then did 6,300 to your opponent. So...
Listen, it's fair and honest gaming, Tarot. Fair and honest gaming.
Of course.
Alright, next is Himeas showing some very interesting Majin Buu.
Okay, let's go.
Take Himeas. A look at the combo.
One of the Buu monsters.
What is happening?
Whoa!
How many side switch were there?
Yeah, this is the ultimate side switch combo, bro. And then the float just for fun.
Like...
very sick.
So he gets one side switch there, into vanish. Another one.
I mean, that was two right there.
Yeah, and then baby, like reside switch. That's like really weird.
And then put himself in the corner, the float, and then the DRs. It looks sick though.
It does.
Stylish combo, you know.
It's obviously not optimal or anything, but you know it. In this house, we stand the sauce.
Keeping it stylish.
Yeah, that is what we want to ask to Himeas for this one. Up next is El Padre Shanks.
Oh, let's go.
Who's labbing a bit. Yeah, I think a lot of us saw this one. Simple, efficient, mix that Android 18 can do as long as she has like any assist. Because remember that assist is pretty low in block stun. And it's a good luck because she gets high enough to get the three overheads.
Yeah, I saw this. This is really good. This is definitely legit, I think.
You can't fuzzy block, yeah.
Yeah.
I saw the discussion. Alun was trying a few ways out, and you can't fuzzy block it. You're blocking the first instant air dash hit, and then you're literally guessing between low or high.
Yeah, that's really really sick.
Yeah.
This is gonna schmick some people. I'm telling you.
Definitely. Like, you're usually standing. You expect maybe two hits, right? But she gets three, or she gets the landing. Mm. Like the third one would 100% hit a lot of people.
Yeah, yeah, exactly.
So, oh, you know, you get like the second one. And because the jump page like starts, you don't see the standel coming out.
Exactly.
Shanks is ready to schmix people up. And speaking of schmix, this one, okay. It's sacrificing damage, but I actually like the idea.
Okay, let's check it. Ooh.
Trunks level 3.
So he can get that without any extra bar.
Well, it's half a bar because it's the hedge flip.
That's true.
But it's basically the same as mid-screen, basically.
I mean,
he saves hedge flip.
Yeah, he saves himself the spend and vanish, right? So he saves himself half a bar.
Yeah, but the thing is, at the cost of damage, because, you know, the half a bar, do it after the extension.
Yeah, it might not be worth it. And you're probably going to build half a bar anyway, doing the extra bit, you know? So... Yeah. It might not be worth it in the long run, but it's nice to know that he can do this, you know?
It's just good to know if your combo is not going to kill anyway, you know, it's definitely one that can work. Shout out to Totsu. For this one, up next is Synergy. And this time it's from Jordan B, showing some base Vegeta and Android 21 Synergy. It's definitely a pair that I've seen a lot.
Yeah. I think two of the strongest characters in the game for sure.
Yeah. So you get the corner. So you get the mixed version of the level 3.
The manga colors look so good on 21.
It's like everyone needs them.
Yep.
Everyone Ooh. Actually needs them, man.
That's sick.
Yeah, you get a clean side switch into level 3. Clean.
Mm.
And you get the left right after this.
Yeah, that's clean. Really sick.
Snack time. Shout out to Jordan B for this one. More chemistry is from Varmar saying illegal mix.
Illegal mix, yeah.
Watch.
Man, like Bardock. A lot of people dropped off with Bardock, man. Oh my god, what? Shitty! Yeah, where's he gonna go? Oh yeah, back to the corner! Oh!
And you get the corner. That's clean!
That is sick. That is really sick, actually.
That's clean because you can still steal the corner, so you still have the left right after this.
Yeah.
And I'm guessing that if you get hit by this in the game, you'll just be like, whoa, what happens?
Yeah,
you're not ready to block, you know?
Yeah, the first time you get hit by this, you're gonna be so confused. That's like so guaranteed.
Schmix.
Yeah.
That's guaranteed. Yeah. The first time is guaranteed. Shout out to Bama for this one. A bit more is Agni Kai showing the optimal 2H extension solo for Beerus.
Okay.
Jeez.
Ooh.
Shout out to Hamad. Yeah. Out there saying haram mix, not illegal. Yeah, haram indeed.
Oh, my I man. Agree. Of course. Oh, sorry, I didn't even see that. He dropped another donation. These bombos. Hell yeah, the bombos are moving. Hamad, for sure, bro.
We got bombos. We got haram mixes. We got all of them. Look at the bar, man.
Yeah, that
7.6K of a 2H.
7.6. So good.
That's like...
Lord Beerus. 2H damage now as well? I feel like this character gets explored more than any other.
Because the people who play him are kind of... You know, kind of crazy.
The dedication is there for this character, I'm telling you.
He gets so much, man.
Yeah, he does. Damn.
And there we go.
Dunk into level 3. Nice.
Massive damage.
5.8 before level 3. So good.
Send 7.6 there. Like, excellent. One shout out to Agnika. And after that, it is some more Beerus because it never stops. And it is the Vanish Loop. But a bit different.
Ooh.
Sneeze.
Got Fierce cold.
Not wearing a mask.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying, man. You got to keep that mask on. That's just for fun, right?
Yeah, that's like, you know, you want to have some fun, you want to have cool. Man said Corona Loops. Exactly.
The Corona Loops. Yeah, for
reminds
sure.
me of Alucard's online tag that was Corona Beerus for a while. So that's exactly what Corona Beerus does.
Achoo!
spreads all the germs. Spreads all the germs. Up next, we got something that a bit cursed. Remember that our boy DSP Shock discovered the mods?
Oh my god. This is so cursed. Oh my god, this is so cursed.
The combo is kind of nice still, you know? But... Like, but wait for the spin. Look at this!
Oh! The Squidward beam cannon. Okay. Oh no. Oh my god, the zoom in is too much. Yo. SpongeBob was getting clapped.
SpongeBob was getting bodied, man.
You know how much Squidward hates SpongeBob. This is actually what he dreams of every day. Just beating the shit out of SpongeBob SquarePants, fam.
That's exactly what he wants to
do. Yeah. This is the Squidward Dream DLC. Look at this. And in the follow-up.
Have you seen the orb? Like, look at Piccolo's orb.
Yeah.
So it's going to do a U-turn.
Yeah. That's
goes left, back to right.
That's godlike.
Listen. Cursed mods are a thing, and I know that... And I know that DSP Shock is one of those who has really been pushing that. Much love to you. Up next, this is probably the biggest bit of tech this week, which is kind of crazy, and it's Fenrich.
Uh-huh.
Fenrich showing the best way to get that punish.
Okay.
That was cursed indeed. Hamad, much love to you. Look at this. You try to vanish out. No.
Oh, the follow up?
That is ghast. So you have to blink, assist and vanish.
Right.
And depending on like what assist you have, right? A lot of assists will just like keep him out of the corner, so you don't get the smash or anything, and you get the extension.
That's crazy.
So,
wow!
Right, so now you can't vanish out of the corner anymore.
Apparently not.
Can't vanish. I definitely want to see if that works with my assist, because that's huge. A lot of people try to get away from the corner.
Yeah, it's really really good to know that.
And you know what? How about, so of course Fenris did this, so a lot of people have been trying their luck. And Faisal Dante shows us this.
Let's go.
His own version.
The Zamasu King.
Yeah, so basically, imagine trying to vanish out of the corner.
Oh,
and
man.
Absolutely dying for that.
And then he did the jump H light link as well. Flexing. Oh, you're dead, by the way.
Yes. You are dead.
The power of a god.
You wanted to vanish. Plus, remember that usually when someone vanishes out of the corner, he's not in full life. You know, he's not 100% in life. Usually at this point, he's been sent to the corner. So that combo would guaranteed kill anyway.
Bro, if you're aware, like super aware, you know, like some of these top players are, this is so viable. I mean, I don't think many high level players will be using vanish out the corner anyway, but just even being aware of this option is insane. And it really does show the levels that this game is reaching.
Yeah, absolutely.
When tech like this is just, you know, a thing, it's nuts.
It's kind of crazy. So it's like off a vanish, only had one assist available, 10k exactly. That's Faisal Dante, and I see Faisal Dante, and I raise you a Talios. Thanks for playing. Go. You are not dead.
Man like Hamad dropping through again. Said goodnight, lads. Stay safe. Thank you so much for stopping through and supporting the content, man.
Much love to you, man like Hamad. So this one requires spark, but you're still dead.
Yo.
Goodbye.
Tien as well. Just for the...
And it's Janemba, which is not a great level 3, so you can see that.
About average.
Yeah, the damage is kind of crazy. Look at this.
That's insane, dude. That's insane.
It's so good.
Yeah, being able to keep that spark up is mad. Off of a vanish.
It's too good. Like, I'm looking forward to see this in match now.
And I hope that they, you know, I don't see why they would, but I hope they don't decide to change this or nerf this or whatever.
Because that's actually cool. Like, that's,
yeah.
You need to have a big brain to. I would get mad hype if someone does this in match.
Yeah, you need to have big awareness to do this. So, yeah, this is sick.
Absolutely. Much love to Taylor for this one. Moving to more TODs. TOD section is open. And the first TOD is a classic. You know, when Nem submits something, it's going to circle his opponents.
Oh, of course. Let's go, Nem.
This is another Nappa circles his opponent, because why not?
The Cyberman's helping out as well. Yo, the dunks. I love that. The the moonwalk back dash into the DR. So
sick.
Oh
my god.
That was really cool. That was like a very creative TOD.
It is. I love his TODs. Every time he tags me on TODs, I know the TOD is going to be like...
Yeah.
He's going to have some extra spice.
Oh, absolutely. I love this. Woo! Let's go.
It's like my man is just freestyling.
Come on, man. You already punched his arm off, Nappa. You don't have to do him like this. Poor Tien. Oh,
poor Tien indeed. Get bodied into base Goku. That is dead. Now to a more practical one that I really like. So Alun was trying to get TODs with a Flash Nose team.
The Sensei.
Yep, and that's a really cool idea. So from a 2H, zero bars.
Mid-screen.
So you swap to the character who has better meter builds.
Oh, that's so smart. And it's always so good to have these mid-screen 2H TODs.
There you go. You dead?
Very nice.
That combo built an entire 5 bars.
Yep, Android 17. He's an absolute... Well, you know, he's an Android, man. He's an absolute battery. Yeah. He's a battery.
And I like the idea, you know, to do a TOD that changes to 117 as soon as possible so you can use his meter gain.
Yeah, very smart. Look, he builds like a full bar with his jump S.
Yeah. Boom.
So sick.
Goodbye. That's a really cool one. Shout out to Alun for this. Speaking of DPs, we've got the Prince Von just showing a cleaner TOD of a DP because we like those.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Imagine getting a DP and dying.
I mean, when you use that, you use it as a defensive option anyway. You know, you just want to activate Spark. But if you hit them and get a TOD as well, that's a big bonus, you know?
Bro, like, I can't lie. Like, this is crazy because you do DP into Spark, that's safe, right?
Exactly.
So it's literally a safe,
it's a win-win
defensive option that leads to a TOD.
That's what I'm saying. It's you just throw it out there because, oh, I'm getting pressured. I want a Spark. Let's do it like this. And if it hits, oh, okay, you die.
Yeah.
So. Damn. So sick.
That's like, ouch. That's too good. And that's a medium DP, right? Oh, wait, let me check. Oh, light DP. Light DP for Tingo, and of course, medium, you get way more scaling. Up next is Jesselina, who I ordered a 2H TOD like you, a Tyrant, last week, and Jesselina delivered.
Oh, let's go.
So I like this, you know.
Yeah, that's great. It's always good to have those.
Yeah, it's hard to get 2H TODs with Jennemba.
Ah, I bet it
because
is.
Because his moves, he doesn't build, like, you have the choice between building meter or doing damage, but not both. So the TODs that do damage require meter. The TODs that need to build meter are very limited in damage, and they usually need CSs. But Jesselina found this one for me, which is really cool.
Very nice. Summit to lab. Shout out to Jesselina, by the way, big supporter of the content and the streams. So
yep, she was there earlier and sent the massive 5 gift subs. So much love to her. Really like this one.
Nice.
Cheese. I'm definitely going to like this one. Shout out to Jesselina for this. Love this. Up next, this one is a Jiren and Super Baby TOD that only needs Jiren and Super Baby with 0 bars as well. Look at this.
Man, Jiren.
Only need 1 assist.
Oof.
It's 0 bar.
Oh, he builds. He's a beast, this character. I think he's really good.
Dead. That's really cool to have this. Only 1 assist with you.
Yeah, it is nice to have that.
And he gets enough to get the second call of the B assists.
I
really like this one. That's a very, very cool concept. And if you're able to TOD with only 1 assist, that's a win. You should have to Sir Phoenix.
Definitely.
For this. Up next is Ronin showing a bit of how much meter you could build with a Super Broly TOD.
Let's go.
I like seeing how much you can make, especially because I have a team that, aside from Adol Gohan, I can't really do a positive TOD with my team.
Bro.
So I watch them with mild jealousy.
The damage. Oh my goodness. He's nearly 9k and he hasn't even used the super yet.
There you go. Plus 2.
That's ridiculous. Man. With no shirt off, though.
Boom.
Yeah.
So, if he had no shirt, he would just need another level 1.
Yeah, just another level 1. Exactly.
So, you would only have a plus 1 bar.
Still great.
Jeez.
That's a nice one.
Yeah, that 1041. I like this one. Shout out to Running for always being the optimal man, but... You know what? I mean, when we speak about positive, you know, of the amount of bars you could do. So, say this happens. It's round start, yeah?
Beerus.
You got Spark.
Beerus unties the shoelaces.
Yeah. Beerus is just like sliding in your DMs. How many bars do you walk away from this after killing that cell?
Well, I'm guessing it's Spark after this. I'm going to say 6 or 7, man. The amount of tech this character has now. With those 2 assists as well? Yeah, 7.
Yeah. So it's mid-screen, right? He saw in the corner that you could get like more than six. Mid-screen is even harder. I see three, I see five, I see seven, I see six.
I think six. Six or seven.
Let's take a look.
Because I see baby and Janember assist.
2M start, man. And you get a DP that builds so much meter, man. Assists are coming back. And two level ones.
Oh,
and
there that's you dead, go.
That is exactly five bars.
That's so crazy.
From A to M.
You love to see it.
Five bars. Mid screen.
The combo doesn't even look hard.
Yeah, it's literally like DP assist, DP assist.
Yeah. And then just ABC, DP assist, dunk. Yeah, it's the easiest combo ever.
It's a UI Goku TOD.
Yeah. Damn.
Wow, I love, man. This.
That is
I
sick.
Love this. Talios is always pushing that character to the limits. It's every time I see Talios tagging me, I'm like, okay, what kind of crazy thing is it gonna be there?
Exactly. What kind of nonsense are we gonna see next with Beerus? That's nuts.
It's so good. Plus five bars, man. Plus five bars, shout out to Talios. And Talios tags me and is like, you wanna play this team yet? I'll crack at one point, Talios. These days, I'll take a full week off work and I'll just lap that team.
Yeah, right.
That's awesome.
Eventually end up playing them.
that took super fun. That we close the TOD section, and you know what that means.
Oh, let's go. It's time to get cursed, boys. Here we go.
Time to get cursed indeed. We've got a lot of cursed entries as always. It's starting to be it's been the most popular entry category for quite a while. Let's go for cursed. The butter cursed is out there. It is time for cursed. Let's start with cursed labbing. That's my favorite kind of curse. Like, you know what? My games are not cursed enough, so I'm gonna lab. K the Supreme is entering the Kremesis land.
All right, let's check it out. Oh my god! Already, what on earth? Jiren, Captain America, Jiren, Stars and Stripes. What?
Yo, what
that
is
was
happening?
That was godlike. That was godlike, by the way. Was that a C assist? Had to be.
I've never seen that before.
That was sick.
I've never seen that before.
I have never seen that before. What happened? Charging Star. That's actually a Charging Star. Boom. Yeah. Oh, yeah, it's a C assist. And then I guess...
Damn.
Oh, my God. What on earth? That's so weird how it drags him down.
Yeah, he really falls down in quite a janky way.
Yeah, it must be the second part of the C assist that knocks him down.
Yeah.
That's
it's so... I don't know how you come up with this.
Cursed combo.
Has, like, you know, it has the cursed super dashes as well, like this one.
Okay. When you get hit by this in a match, that's when you know they're for real, you know?
Exactly. It's like, let's
they're
go.
Not, they're not playing around. They're not playing around. They're here to style. They're here to source. You know?
Oh my god. K the Supreme said, I tried. Well, you succeeded. You succeeded. Up next is...
I guess a big curse for me right there.
Yeah. This one I love. So, McLovin is there with the biggest brain. And he said, who said baby B assist doesn't have counterplay? So he's waiting there full screen. He's waiting for the B assist. He's waiting.
Okay, he's waiting.
Yeah, the B assist is
there. It is. Oh! Get the hell out of here, man.
You know, this is actually amazing because you cannot get a big punish of that Genki Dama. You can only get like a super dash, or maybe if you're in Spark, you can get an empty vanish, right?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. So if you've got like a lot of life like this Goku, this is perfectly viable because you eliminate one of their characters in the exchange for some damage, which is fine. Yeah.
And Janemba is, like, in this situation, will, like, not even get a big mix because, like, it's mid-screen level 3.
Yeah, exactly.
It's actually a legit solution. I actually really like this.
Yeah, this is great. I wonder if you can do this with other characters as well. Like, obviously, if you have your own baby, you could use the same move. But yeah. I wonder. This is sick.
Yeah, you need a good level 3 to finish that. Much love to McLovin for the big brain. Up next, the classic, right? We know that this week was the 3 years anniversary of Dragon Ball FighterZ. And Kremesis says, thanks for giving us this great mechanic.
Okay.
21 seconds of fun.
Okay. God bless the super dash.
What?
What? Oh my god. Whoa! Wait. Ah, the only thing that can avoid the revenge death ball is, of course, the cursed super dash. It's the only thing that can avoid it.
That was literally like, you know what? I'm going to find the most cursed sequence I could think of.
Yeah, that's nuts.
I can't. This interaction is so weird.
It's, yeah, it's just. I don't know.
Can't too keep, good.
You can't beat the super dash, man.
Listen, super dash is the best mechanic. That's what Kremisius says. And you know what? Let me show you more super dash. First is Cringeman saying, "I think I've been cursed for playing Frieza."
Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Just look at the trail behind the super dash. It's like up, down.
These are easily the most painful super dashes to be. Like, the way they... Like, look, the way they just completely change is crazy. It's... I don't even know what to say. It's actually crazy.
It is. It's nuts.
Next, another super dash is from Kremisius this time. As always, I want to say.
Oh, of course. You've got to love it. That actually like looked like it confused the game because the screen went all weird.
It's like, I don't even know why.
I don't know, man. Like, these super dashes are getting out of control.
I don't know what to say. Like, so Trunks here is learning a new flip, right? Like, that's like the higher flip license. But you know what? On Wanted Tuesday, we actually had the biggest flip license of all time. Take a look. Let me just refresh this because Twitter is destroying everything. Take a look, take a look. So this is the worst super dash I've ever seen.
He went up, then down, then up. That was wild. And I swear it always happens on these...
That was like, in the middle of OB versus Kaiden, right? There was like high pressure moments.
That was crazy. Yeah.
Trunks was literally right. Where do I go? Where do I go? Where do I go?
Because there was nothing to lock onto, I guess. I don't know. That was weird.
Me and C4 just like, let's not talk anymore. Let's watch the game.
So crazy.
Oh my god. SDs are sick, but now it's AXG showing us another of these cursed situations.
Okay, let's check it out.
What's going to happen?
What's going to happen
there?
16. Dash. Wait, what did 16 do? Super dash? Well, I want to say 16 loses and gets hit. I mean, that's what I hope happens, you know? Just for my sanity.
Super dash gonna work. Super dash gonna get, he's gonna get hit.
Broly gets bonked. Yeah, that's most likely, right?
Let's check.
Whoa! It hit! It traded? What happened? I mean, 16 died. Oh man, Broly didn't even move. He didn't even budge an inch. The legendary Super Saiyan, man. He doesn't move for no robots. Look at this. Bam!
Nope.
Damn!
Get hit by these big techs. Shout out to XG. I would be salty too, man. I would be salty too.
Yeah.
On this one. Another one. This is Kenshin saying, "Let's play. Who won?" So let's see.
AXG says the final hit of the level 3 hitbox expanded beyond this. Yeah, it just, it was huge. Damn.
All right, guys, look at the situation. Who wins?
Okay, I actually don't know. See, Broly level 3. Broly level 3 is a weird one. It's so hard to predict.
I have Broly, I have Clash, I have Baby.
No idea.
I have plenty of ways. I have plenty of Broly. I have Clash. Let's go, let's take a look.
Baby is canonically stronger, so he wins. Yeah, I agree.
Well, get
Yo! Body. Let's go, get Baby. Body. Look at this. No life in it as well. I bet both players were like, huh?
AXG is in the chat and is like, yes, I hope Broly loses. I know, like, this is for you. This is redeeming it.
Yeah, this one was for you, bro. Damn, Baby. Holding it down.
Why not?
fair enough. Yeah, this one's weird. Was it? And that was the fast one as well, so.
Yeah. So, okay. GG's. GG's. That's when you say GG's, you know. You just say GG's.
How to play,
next. This one comes from Reddit, and
wow, this is actually actual tech on DBFZ Reddit, by the way.
Not tech highlights.
Oh, okay.
Tech highlights. let's be real, Tyrant. Let's be real.
Oh my goodness, let's go! Revenge Decibel. Whoa, what the hell happened? What the hell?
By the way, that guy's name is Frame Advantage. Oh yeah, can you get him the copyright strike?
Wait, I'm gonna send the troops over.
Send him the DMCA.
Yeah.
Oh.
What happened?
Like.
So it traded. He got like one hit of it, and then he froze up. It's so weird.
It actually, yeah, it looks like one of Shoyo Momo's videos. That's what it looks like.
Yeah. Oh, he's actually hitting a character. Did he kill a character there?
Did he hit someone or?
Yeah, it got some damage. It said all the hits. Yeah, he's wait.
What did he hit then?
Oh, he hits.
Bezoku has no life.
He hits the super baby assist, dead assist.
Damn, that's so weird.
Baby called an assist.
That's. So he killed the dead assist. Let's be overkill.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah,
that one was good.
Yeah, that's such a weird one that you can combo dead characters, like the assist, and it counts as hits. It's really, really strange.
It is strange, but it'd be like that sometimes. And now I have a lot of outplayed moments. So as always, let's watch people getting outplayed. First is Sif.
He already missed the super. Oh my god, that auto combo just annoys the hell out of me, man. Look. When in doubt, mash. The guys that do auto combo, regardless of the situation, scare the hell out of me, bro.
You know, I said it before, right? Not only are they scary, this is a mentality, a mindset I cannot have in this game.
Yeah, I agree. I feel
like it's wrong to do auto combo. It's not, but in my brain, it's wrong.
No, I know what you're saying. Like, it's... Like, I wouldn't be able to just try and commit to an option like that if I know it's not hitting the opponent, you know? The only way I would use it is to turn around. Actually, in that situation, it's not the worst thing ever, because sometimes, you know, if you commit to the button, the only way to turn around is to fully go for the full thing because of the way the game works, which is a shame, but...
I'm Boden.
Yeah. I'm Boden.
That's all I can say. I'm Boden. Sif, you got I'm Boden.
Next
is SMobs saying this game sucks.
Oh god, what's it gonna be? What cursed entity? Oh my god!
I would actually rage quit if this happens to me.
That is the most.
I would legit Alt F4.
Straight after that doesn't work. You're taking that just annoying auto combo that you've seen a million times as well.
You're literally being punished for doing the right thing.
Yeah, you anti-ed. You know, you did the right thing. Oh man, that's so annoying. Big feels bad.
Outplayed. More outplayed is McDonald's Toy saying I got outplayed by Superior Enix. Let's take a look. Outplayed.
I love, by the way, his name, Learn to Use Your Brain.
Yep, well, he does.
If I get hit by this and the guy's gamer tag is Learn to Use Your Brain, I'm rage quitting. I'm out of there.
Get unbooted. Get unbooted.
That's so good.
Oh my god, that one is
amazing.
Another one. Shadow saying, you know, he just outplayed me so hard I might have to go sit on the roof of my house and contemplate my life. <Let's see.
laughs> Oh no.
That's actually like, I don't even know what to say.
This is just the UI feels bad section, to be honest.
Like, bro!
Oh man. Cause you know the UI player is thinking to himself, yeah, gassed! I'm sick! That was sick! What a read!
You were not looking for that, fam. You were just buffering it.
I know.
Auto Brado!
You know he thinks he's so sick for that as well. He's like, yeah, in his house. Yeah! Bro.
Outplayed. And just saying, you know, if you ever have this, you can actually TOD of this, right? So
yeah. Like... Definitely.
Oh my god, outplayed. Listen, outplayed Shadow. Up next is Kasuga getting outplayed. This one I love.
Okay, let's see it. Ooh.
Why did the barrier got eaten? He was like, punch your barrier, your assist, your Beerus, and everything.
Yeah. Wait a sec. Let me... Because... Wait, did he take out 18? I can't see because like, there's like a dust cloud that comes up.
Well, the thing is, like, he hit, like, he clearly hit the barrier. It's just that the 2H was active longer.
Yeah,
and I guess that Beerus came there exactly when needed.
Yeah.
It's crazy.
Man, that's so annoying.
It's actually crazy. It's so weird. And the fact that it hit 18 like this makes it even crazier.
That's nuts.
It's just because Beerus, like, gets hit, it counts as both hits because it hits her at the same time. It's really strange. Kasuga, get better in it. Get good in it. Next one is Legend 27. I'm not gonna say anything.
Okay. Bro! What happened? Why did he do that? So many questions.
I have so many questions. It looks scripted, you know?
He thought... The guy thought he was sick, you know?
I think he wanted to do himself the walk forward into command ground.
Yeah.
But that Goku Blue was like, nah, I got you. He had to inform him that he had it.
Yeah.
You know, it's like...
Let him know.
Let him know. You want to let him know as well? Take a look at this one.
Oh okay. My god. Absolutely scooped. Damn.
Outplayed.
Hold that.
What can I say?
Wow. You can't even be mad.
You can't. That's actually canon. You can't be mad. If Yamcha tried this on Broly, this is exactly what would happen.
Scooped up immediately.
Scooped up. Absolutely scooped up. I have to enjoy it. For this one, one more for you guys. This one is massive, massive outplayed as well.
What? Oh man.
What's your toe? Excuse me, your shoes, your laces are untied. Let me
look how close look how close he was to getting hit by the key blast as well though.
As perfect timing, that was amazing.
The base Vegeta player must have literally like sat back in his chair like, bro, what? Excuse me?
I would just like give a slow clap, you know. I would
Damn.
Just give a slow clap.
Well, you can't be mad.
That's all I would go for.
You got scooped.
and to close the curse section, I have got the single weirdest Genki-Dama ever from Gila.
Okay.
I don't think I've ever seen this interaction.
That does work. Whoa! Did it all combo?
No, that did not.
Oh, okay. He just gave up.
He just like, the other one was like, oh, I'm dead. Like, I understand, right? If the Genki-Dama comes out, I'm just dead. I'm just like,
yeah.
I'm just done. But why?
That is so strange.
Only the first hit connected and it sent Janemba down.
Yeah. It looks like he went to float up into it, but then he didn't get juggled by the rest, so he just fell down.
Yeah.
That is very bizarre.
That's a super like edge gaze as well.
I've never seen that happen.
I don't know what to say. Get better. that's really weird. There was a similar one like with Beerus. It's probably just like high hit stun decay and a perfectly on the edge of the Genki-Dama hit. You know, it's probably what happened.
Yeah.
That will close the curse section. We have one entry to Soul Sword Sleep this week.
Oh, okay. We're going to get it.
Yeah. So as always, for you guys who are new to Sparking Cast every week, we have a combo contest called Soul Sword Sleep. The rule is pretty simple. People are submitting combos online and they're asking for the question, which is Soul. So is this combo Soul? Is this combo really cool? Or is this combo Sleep? Like, do you fall asleep watching this combo? Is it like not interesting at all? And you guys in the chat are judging the combo. We have one entry.
Yep, let's go, guys. Should be good. Let's see. Oh, we've got Rice. Okay.
It's from Rice.
We're in for a good one.
Let's go.
Oh, training mode only. Training mode only combos.
I don't understand how he does that, man. He changes the assist so fast as well. Like, bro...
Oh my god, this is sick.
What is happening?
Bro, like, to me, the most impressive part about these, Source, by the way, the most impressive part about these is remembering all the menu options.
Yeah.
And all the timings.
Yeah, because he literally, like, has optimal execution on the menu changes.
Oh, let's go. That's sick, because you would never see that. The powered up Kamehameha from the Kaioken. Like, it looks like you can DHC get a follow-up after it. But you'd never see that because he has to be dead, right? He has to be the last character.
Yeah.
So that's sick, because you would never see that.
Massive.
This is sick.
Massive training mode source.
Yeah.
Cheat engine combos, yeah.
Yeah, Rice is always pushing the limits of the training mode combos, man. This is godlike.
I like this, you know, like, you don't have to just look for actual combos. Like,
I swear the only way he was building meter was with the base Goku assist.
Yeah.
So he actually was just using that to build bar. Super sick.
That's so good.
Yeah, this is godlike.
That's so good. Man saying, can we just keep the vote whenever Rice submits and go straight to the tweet? I understand.
Yeah, yeah.
I completely understand. I'm going to share the tweet because everyone is saying that it's mad sauce. And all we do is we just send some love to man like Rice.
Hell yeah.
Just going to go for most unpractical sauce known to man. So that's exactly what it is. That's exactly what it is. Link is shared. Do make sure you go and send some love to Rice, because this one is cool. And as you can see, guys, the source or sleep doesn't require the combo to be practical or to be real or to be optimal or anything. It's just a combo that makes us look at it and say, yo, that's kind of cool.
Yeah, and of course, you know, like, I love seeing stuff like this because it just shows creativity. It shows using the game's training mode to its fullest. Yeah, you can't do this in a match, but it looks cool as hell, so...
Exactly.
I like it.
That's, yeah, that is pretty much all you need. Much love to Rice, as to all of you guys, for bombing his Twitter with this. Rice is there. One entry this week. One entry is Sauce. And of course, as always, Tyrant. Last but not least is the little cool thing of the week. And I feel like this is an easy cool thing to find. It's our boy Crash Video. With another canon fight. Yeah, Krillin Zamasu.
Okay. Okay. Let's check it out. Krillin versus Zamasu. The power
definitely
of
what would happen.
The power of a god versus the best rocks in the West, you know? Those rocks.
These are mad cool.
Yeah, this is sick. I love these. Ooh, Krillin! Ultra Instinct Krillin, yeah? Oh! I've never seen that.
He's so cool.
Destructo Desk! That is sick. Very, very
and
cool.
Of course it finishes on a tie, because that's what would happen if Krillin was actually fighting Zamasu.
Yeah, why didn't they bring him, man? Trunks was like, oh, we need Goku and Vegeta. No, you need Krillin, fam. Man, like
Krillin, the rocks. So for those of you who don't know Crash Video, he usually makes extremely canon Clash videos, like exactly what happened in the anime, but today he was like, nah, I'm gonna just find something a bit saucy on this.
Yeah.
And that one is definitely cool.
Ultra Instinct Krillin, this is so sick. Very cool.
Ultra Instinct Krillin. But that, guys, we close Sparking Cast episode 48. As we said, four more episodes until we have a full 1 year of Sparking Cast. I appreciate all of you guys joining, submitting stuff. And remember that whenever you see some cool stuff online, all you have to do is this. What Rice does, you tag both of us, the Damascus, Tyrant.co.uk, and use the hashtag Sparking Cast for us to see it, because that's what we want to see.
Yes, please, guys, go ahead and do that if you want to be featured on the show. Send us your tech. Really appreciate all the support the show's been getting. Nearly at a full year of Sparking Casts. So, yeah, let's keep it moving, man. And shout-outs to everybody watching, whether it's on Twitch, YouTube. You guys are what make the show. So thank you so much, everybody.